This episode of Sexplanations is sponsored by AdamandEve.com.
Look at this. This is a big mushroom. That's a big head. What do you think?
This is a model of an IUD, which stands for intrauterine device. It's a form of birth control that goes in the uterus. A medical provider uses a speculum to open the vagina, makes sure that there's a straight path, slides the applicator with the IUD in through the opening in the cervix called the os, pushes the slide to guide the IUD out slightly to the top of the uterus, and then pushes the lever to retract the applicator, leaving the IUD behind. Pretty simple. The question is it safe? When I first learned about IUDs, they were restricted to people who'd already had children. If you learned oliparous, the clinical term to describe someone who hasn't given birth, then IUDs weren't presented as an option. Why? Well, unfortunately, in the long history of IUDs, among the many designs and materials used for decades, a version called the Dalkin Shield destroyed their reputation, especially as a method for people who might want to have kids later. From 1970 to the mid-80s, over 400,000 users experienced bleeding, pain, infection, abdominal injuries, pelvic inflammatory disease, and or post-use infertility. Furthermore, the IUD didn't prevent pregnancy in some users. They got pregnant and spontaneously aborted or miscarried. Some users were advised to get hysterectomies due to IUD complications, and then there were those who died. The company responsible for Dalkin Shields ended up paying close to $3 billion in reparations, and the IUD market plummeted. Now, though, we know far more about IUDs, pregnancy prevention, and disease. The IUDs on the market today have been designed to avoid old mistakes and are 99% effective at preventing pregnancy. For example, modern IUDs only have one or two unwoven plastic strings hanging down, so physicians can easily make sure that they're still in place, rather than the multi-strand nylon cord used in Dalkin Shields that served as a racetrack for bacteria. In the 1970s, the FDA, that oversees food, drug, and other healthcare products, only intervened on a distribution of something like an IUD if a problem came up. Now, all medical devices, IUDs included, have to be approved by the governing health groups like the FDA before they go on the market. In the past, IUDs were inserted through the cervix, but they were less aerodynamic and the procedure involved fewer tools. Now, physicians measure the depth and position of the uterus, use a speculum to see what they're doing, and special Sharon forceps if they need a guide. They also rinse the cervix and vagina in antibacterial solution before inserting the IUD, because we know more about infections and prevention. In the past, there were more undiagnosed chlamydia and gonorrhea cases, which the Dalkin Shield and IUDs in general took the blame for, even though they weren't the cause. Now there's more health promotion for people to get tested and treated. We have antibiotics and teach open communication about risk so that there are fewer infections to blame on IUDs. Current IUDs are one of the most effective and safest contraceptive methods. Wariness from older family members, medical providers, even educators is just a matter of them learning about the current IUDs. Consider all of these benefits. They're more effective than the pill, patch, ring, condoms, spermicides, and fertility awareness. You don't have to regularly buy, replace, swallow, put on, or put in anything. An IUD is placed once and can last 3 to 12 years depending on the type you choose. They work almost immediately at preventing pregnancy, and hormonal forms can help alleviate painful bleeding and cramping endometrial hyperplasia and endometrial cancer. They're tucked away out of sight, very private, so that it's more difficult to be coerced into pregnancy. And they are quickly reversible. If you ever change your mind and decide that you don't want an IUD inside you, you can take it out with the help of a professional. This is not to say that IUDs don't come with their risks and are only beneficial. They can hurt terribly when put in. Watch out for dizziness and fainting. IUDs can cause spotting or full-on irregular bleeding and pain that lasts for 6 months. Tender breasts, headaches, acne, cysts, and fluctuations in mood. Hormonal IUDs can severely exacerbate PMS and PMDD symptoms like cramping, achiness, and back pain. Tell your medical provider. I sound like a commercial. The strings, which are supposed to be helpful indicators that everything is in place, can be irritating to both the vagina and objects of insertion. One of the most serious complications with IUDs is infection within the first few months. This may lead to fever, pelvic pain, abnormal vaginal fluid, inflammation in the reproductive system, and infertility. Or be asymptomatic, meaning that you're sick from the IUD but have no signs to tell you. get checked. An article published in OBG Management reports that, quote, IUD expulsion is common with a rate of approximately 3% to 11%, in which the IUD comes out sometimes without the person knowing. And even more common is IUD malposition, which occurs in 10% to 20% of patients, where the IUD is not where it's supposed to be, either because it was incorrectly placed or moved on its own. An IUD being out of place can cause a perforation of the uterus. According to the National Institute of Health, perforation may be complete or with the device totally in the abdominal cavity or partial, with the device to varying degrees within the uterus wall. That's 1 in 1,000 patients. Lastly, of all the complications is ectopic pregnancy. In the 1% chance that a person does get pregnant using an IUD, there's an increased risk that the pregnancy will embed in the fallopian tubes outside of the uterus where it should be. This tiny little device packs a lot of power. It's been around for a long time with a lot of history and innovation, and it has its pros and cons. To know what's right for your body and have a longer discussion about IUDs, talk to a medical provider and stay curious. Dr. Erin Carroll from the Healthcare Triage has 2 really great videos on the topic, and I've also linked to some articles that helped me understand IUDs more.
Today's sponsor, Adam and Eve, has sent me yet another beautiful, innovative toy. They do this all the time, and it's one of the ways that I feel connected to sexuality and the genius that is out there. Transforming not just the basics of sex ed, but actually where we are in the future. This, look at this. When I opened up the box, I thought this is maybe the coolest one I've seen yet. Look at it! That's a tiny little mushroom! Well, not tiny. This is a big mushroom. That's a big head. What do you think? You like it? You like it? Oh, it's so soft. This part is more squishy. It's still firm, but this part is really firm. This is if you want girth. If you're looking to have the experience of fullness to really open up that orifice, really get in there, this is your toy. And it's cute! 15 functions, submersible, rechargeable, press and hold for ready mode vibration patterns. It's 4.5 inches and its width is 2.2 inches. There we go. You're so beautiful, mushroom. You can go to adamandeve.com to get one of these, all sorts of other toys and accoutrements for your sexual health, and use promo code DOE, D-O-E, my last name, when you check out to get 50% off an eligible item, plus free shipping to the US and Canada. Ah! Thanks, Adam and Eve.
If you were Nella Paris, are you sure? You looked it up, Nella Paris. And a special Sharon for, and special Sharon, exacerbate, not exacerbate.
Right.